Hey guys, what's popping? Aki, my sister, gave me such a challenge. It fell. Oh, she gave me such a challenge to try and vlog with my kittens, which are very noisy. They're very noisy, I swear. So welcome back to my channel. This vlog is about Nairobi Diaries, the new season. I think it's season 9, episode 1 review. I'm going to be very quick about it. Oh my god. Oh. Yeah, so Nairobi Diaries is back after a very long break of I don't even know how they got their show renewed, but fine. We are ready to be entertained by this ratchet slut. Sorry, I have to use that because if you watch the show, they're self-confessed sluts, all of them. So I'm not doing a mistake by calling them by their name. So it started with Ella, and I'm not sure why Nairobi Diaries has to make their cast look like they're always butting heads at the beginning of the show. Kila mtu alirudi na, oh, what alijua, sijini mko madhani atusharudi. They're so full of hate towards each other, towards their audience, towards everybody. I'm like, bro, so you think the only way your reality show will thrive is when you hate on us? Like, bruv, you need us, because come out to watch, you're irrelevant. So I don't understand why they have to. They copy Love and Hip Hop so much, but one thing they don't know is this is not the States, bruv. This is Kenya. You don't just come to your reality show and you start insulting us. Who do you think you are? And most of you are ratchets. Most of you are broke as fuck. Most of you suck. Most of you are ugly. But you'll just come here and start telling us all sorts of nonsense. So like Ella came back. She started saying how she lost her child and shit. And I'm like, you expect us to pity you after you just insulted us, bro? That's your issue. Plus, you were getting so drunk when you were pregnant and you were doing all sorts of nonsense. Like you always do, minding other people's business. I'm sorry you lost your kid, but you kind of deserved it because you were doing all the wrong things people do when they're pregnant. Then there is Bridget. Oh my God, Bridget looks ugly. She looks bad. And this girl, I don't even know where she gets her confidence from when she wakes up. I don't know who lies to her, but she looks ugly as fuck. I really hope that she won't be in the episode for long because she kind of looks like a man, a fat man, something. I was happy to see Mishi back, but I don't like her fake accent. It doesn't even suit her. She's so dark to be faking such an accent. So I hope she, you know, I hope as the show continues, she's going to improve on her accent. Because that guess whatever nonsense accent really sucks. And then there is, who's this other one? Pendo. Oh my God, Pendo, you say that people are jealous of your mzungu boyfriend, really? Like, are you serious? You're not jealous you're dating a grandfather, first a white one, bro. Most of us are into dark people, and most of us know one thing. Like, okay, we already know he left your ass for his former. So he was just teasing you, plus he left you with a whole bill. Sorry, I'm giving you the spoiler, but that is what is going to happen. But listen, some of us are not threatened by white men. So I don't understand why you can just go saying people are jealous of him. Jealous of what, your grandpa? Are you serious? So I'm happy that is happening. Oh, she was so happy about the engagement and all that nonsense. And then she's saying like, she'll invite, I don't know, that people to the beach in Zanzibar. I'm happy that wedding is not even happening. You're so ratchet, you're so ghetto, you're so classless to even get married. So I'm happy that wedding is not happening. Plus, I think women in Africa need to know one thing. Please, not all of us are defined by dating white men, okay? And you guys need to be proud of your African men, black melanated men, because even those white girls can tell you these men are strong. So Pendo, please keep your mzungu whatever to yourself. No one is really interested. First, I didn't even see anyone who was hating. Everybody was just like waiting to see how it unfolds because no one really cares, Pendo. Then Mustafa is back. The noise maker of the show is back. The woman man. You know what? Mtoto ape Mustafa Dera tu akwa kiva because Mustafa is just a man. A woman trapped in a man's body. That guy, I don't even understand him, but I like one thing about him. He's full of good vibes. Like him, he talks too much for a man, and he is just like a person who's back trap King Chrome. I think that's his name. Oh my God, I'm not understanding how they casted this time, but I don't know whether he still has relevance on that show. Like, let's see. Then there's this girl with the booby girl. She used to have nice vibes, but these days she started saying people are jealous of Suji, her boobs and stuff. Yo, you have shiko fever, so I don't understand why you will say people are jealous. Yeah, you have nice boobs, but bro, you don't have an ass, so you have shiko fever. No one wants shiko fever. Anyway, let's wait for next Monday to see what is going to unfold. But honestly, you guys need to stop hating too much on us. This show just started. Why are you being so salty? Anyway, guys, remember to like, comment, subscribe. Till next Monday when I'll do EAGT and Nairobi Diaries and maybe any other interesting show that will come up. Bye.